I found a loophole. So, I was recently scrolling through my Google News feed when I came across an article about upcoming changes to Google Photos. The fact that it was changing at all troubled me. For those who don't know, Google Photos is Google's cloud-based photo and video storage service that allows you to upload unlimited free photos and videos if you're okay with them being compressed a little bit. That is, until June of this year. Google plans to end this unlimited option and instead will now count all new uploads towards your 15 gigabytes of Google Drive. That is not a lot, and it's all to push their new Google One program. So, obviously, I looked for alternatives. iCloud is pretty much identical to Google One, but that also means the pricing is very similar. Amazon has free full-quality photo storage for Prime members, but videos still count towards a quota. There are lesser-known storage programs, but they're all subscription-based and don't have convenient mobile apps like Google Photos. So, I was stumped. It seemed like nothing would ever meet the standards that Google Photos had set for me, so I pulled out my wallet, opened my phone, and decided to read the article again, just in case I missed anything. Wait a minute. If you have a Pixel 1 through 5, photos uploaded from that device won't be impacted. This is really weird. It turns out that Google's phone, the Google Pixel, came with a very special offer to get the phone to sell. If you bought the original Google Pixel in 2016, you'd get free, unlimited, original quality uploads for life through Google Photos. For the Pixel models to come, they tweaked the offers a bit so they could sneakily switch the uploads to compressed quality, albeit still free and unlimited, after a certain date. But the original seems to have a bedrock seal that Google can't touch. So, that got me thinking. I wonder how much the original Pixel sells for. So, I spent a day or two looking at eBay listings for Google's first phone. I also made a Reddit thread in r/GooglePixel building my hypothesis. Theoretically, could I buy a used Google Pixel to take advantage of the unlimited storage? The comments were plentiful, and they seemed to agree. I could. Shortly after, I found my golden listing. A damaged 32GB brown version of the OG Google Pixel, listed for $30. The damages it talked about were a weak battery, light image burn, and a cracked screen, which was a hairline fracture down in the lower left, which is mostly just bezel and not actual screen. None of this was going to be a problem for what I needed it for. I thought to myself, if I was going to do this, this was going to be the only expense I made in the entire process. So, after promising myself, I hit buy. I waited for 4 days and it arrived. So, it was time for some initial testing. I plugged the phone into my PC and it turned on. Great, it works. Wi-Fi, touch feedback, vibration, Google account, they all worked perfectly. So, I downloaded Google Photos. Big test number one. If the unlimited offer was limited to the first account on the phone, or if it could be used on every account. If it was locked, this was all for nothing. But there it was! Backing up from this Pixel is free and unlimited. Okay, big test number two. Will photos taken on another phone be counted towards storage or not? I took a picture with my iPhone, emailed it to myself, downloaded it to my computer, and dragged it into the camera folder on the Pixel. It recognized the picture, and started to upload it. Doesn't look like my storage was affected at all. That's a free 4K photo right there. This was going to work. Now I just had to find a way to automate it. The end goal was a single button on my phone to seamlessly upload all photos and videos to the Google Pixel. Looking up obscure programming stuff on Google stinks! Now that that's out of my system, here's how I got everything to work. My first major attempt was using apps. I must have looked through every file transfer app on the planet, but almost all of them had some sort of storage limitation, or didn't let me choose where the photos went on the Pixel, or required dozens of taps on both ends to get it to work. So I threw that plan out the window. Next, I tried a man-in-the-middle approach. I could keep the Pixel tethered to my computer and sync the files like that. The only feasible way of connecting my phone to the equation was through Dropbox. I could use Siri shortcuts to upload the photos and videos to Dropbox, then a program called Sync Folder to copy the files from the Dropbox folder to the Pixel. Whew, a lot of steps for something that should be fairly simple. However, it could still be done with only one button push. The only problem was that it broke. A lot. Apparently, I was uploading the things to Dropbox too fast or something. So not only did some of the files fail to upload, there also wasn't any way for me to remotely clear out the Pixel storage after the photos were uploaded, which would lead to the phone running out of space. And, oh yeah, another thing. Dropbox only gives you 2 GB of free storage, which wouldn't be enough if you didn't back up for a while. Theoretically, you could get up to 16 GB of bonus space by referring a whopping 32 people to Dropbox, but nobody has 32 friends, and trying to fake it is impossible. Trust me. So that's another thing that doesn't work. I was giving up hope until I thought about servers. If I downloaded an app that essentially turned the Pixel into a file server, I could wirelessly send the files that way. There are so many different types of servers, so at least one of them has to work, right? I tried so many servers. FTP? iPhone couldn't do it. HTTP? Pixel couldn't do it. WebDAV? iPhone couldn't do it. I tried those and so many more until I finally stumbled across SSH. SSH isn't necessarily for files, but rather for executing commands remotely. I didn't try it until last because I figured I'd have much better luck with the file-specific servers. But guess what the Shortcuts app has? A block to execute an SSH command. So I took a few days Googling, testing out different commands, and Googling, until finally, I had my lucky break. The cat command. It just worked! I pushed a button, and all of my files successfully transferred to exactly where I needed them to be. I reopened Google Photos a few times until it recognized the files, and then watched as my full-quality photos and videos were uploaded for free. So now, as long as my phone and the Pixel are on the same network, I can use one shortcut to upload all of my photos and videos, check the Google Photos app after a while to make sure they're all uploaded, and use another shortcut to free up space on both my phone and the Pixel at the same time. It felt good. A project like this is never guaranteed to work, so I was really proud in that moment. I may or may not have jumped up and down a few times to celebrate the transfer. So while the initial project may be complete, there's always more to be done. When I made this video, I saved this bit for the very end. I wrote this part last. And that's because I feel like there's so much more that I can do with this, but I just can't do it alone. I think that this Pixel loophole could allow for unlimited storage, period. By encoding a file as a video, it becomes a format that Google Photos supports. So all we need is a program that can encode a file as a video, send it to the Pixel, and download things from Google Photos when necessary. There are already programs that can encode and decode files as videos, but they are in very early stages and aren't really stable. I also think that the issue of the Pixel's measly storage space could be fixed too, with using an external drive. I think this would work, as you can select other folders for Google Photos to back up from, but I haven't tested this yet. Basically, there's a lot that could be done. So if you know something or know someone who knows something, don't be afraid to reach out to me. Here's my Twitter, here's my Discord. Who knows, maybe this video will have a part 2 someday. But with that, I'm content for now. Since I'm planning on using this until either the Pixel or I die, I thought that you ought to know how to do it too, without all of the garbage that I had to go through. If you want a full step-by-step guide to doing this yourself, including links to my shortcuts and the apps I use to get it working, click the link below the like button or the video in the end card for the guide on my second channel. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.